Hi, this is DrTiv, and welcome to one of my episodes. Today, let's talk about camera setting. Now, with camera settings, there's four things that we're gonna be talking about. ISO, which is how sensitive the film or the sensor is. We're gonna talk about shutter speed, we're gonna talk about aperture, and we're gonna talk about flash settings. So bear with me, once you know this, you're gonna be able to pick up any camera, turn to the right settings, and take a brilliant dental photography. Now, ISO settings, this is one of the easiest things for us to talk about. It's how sensitive the sensor is on the camera. So with modern cameras, you can go from 100, which is low sensitivity, all the way to thousands, which is really high sensitivity. Now, if you have a sensitive sensor, so set it to like 1,000 or 6,000 or 12,000, what's gonna happen is that when you take a photo, you don't need much light at all. You can take it in almost pitch black, but you're gonna get these artifacts. A good example is this diagram. Now on this diagram, on the left-hand side, you'll notice that the image is really sharp and detailed. And as we move towards the right-hand side, it gets grainy. You can see these multicolored kind of speckles going through it. That's noise. That's what happens when you set the ISO too high. So in dental photography, to get sharp images, you want to set the ISO as low as you can, so somewhere between 100 and 200. So the first thing you do when you pick up a dental camera is make sure the ISO is set to 100 or 200. Now the next is shutter speed. Now shutter speed is a bit easier to understand. Basically what it is it's how long the sensor is open for to let light in. So photography is all about letting light in. And the longer you let light in, the brighter the picture is going to be. So if you let light in for a long period of time, you need a really bright image. If you let it in for a short amount of time, it's going to be a darker image. Now the trouble with letting it in for a long period of time is if you shake, you're going to get a smudged image. It's going to look blurry. And for dental photography, because we're zoomed up quite close to the teeth, a tiny bit of movement is going to make the image look blurry. So we want to try and keep the shutter speed as low as possible. Probably 1/250th of a second, 1/200th of a second, somewhere just a fraction of a second, so it kind of takes it and closes it straight away so you can get to freeze time. Now, as I mentioned, the trouble with this is if you don't have a good flash, what's gonna happen is the image is gonna look really dark. But let's come to flash in a second. The third thing we're gonna talk about is aperture. Aperture is basically the amount of light the lens lets into the sensor. So not how long it lets in, that's shutter speed, but how much of it lets in any one time. So you can have a very small opening and then you can let the light in a short amount of time. We can have it really big. Now, the thing with this is the number they use to describe aperture, which is the f-stop, is a ratio, and it's confusing because the smaller the number, the bigger the opening. So an f-stop of 2, for instance, is going to be big. An f-stop of, say, 30 is going to be tiny, a tiny little hole. So this makes it kind of hard if you're not into photography to talk about it, because when you're talking about a bigger opening, you're talking about a smaller number. So bear that in mind. So for dental photography, you might be thinking, well, if I need to keep the opening for a short period of time, the shutter speed fast, so I can't let much light in, and I need to keep the sensitivity low because I don't want graininess, then let's keep the aperture large so we can let lots of light in. Now we have a problem with that. The trouble is the bigger you keep the aperture, so the lower the f-stop, means a less depth of field that you have. Now if you've used loops, you might have understood this. If you're using loops and you're looking at an image, there's a certain range which is going to be in focus. And outside that range, where it's closer or further away, you're going to be out of focus. Same thing happens with dental photography too. So this picture that you're going to see here, you're going to notice that the front teeth are in focus, but the back teeth are not in focus. And the reason for that is I've used a low f-stop, so a bigger aperture opening. Now this next photo that you're looking at here, you can see the front teeth and the back teeth are in focus. I've used an f-stop of 22, which means it's quite small. So for dental photography, you want to have the f-stop high, but not too high, because if you have it too high, you actually get distortions in the image as well. It's just the optics of light, how they go through a small hole, interference of photons, things like that. So for one of these cameras that does the click-click, basically you want to make sure that it's set on 22, so an f-stop of 22. If you have one of those mirrorless cameras, so they're kind of smaller, you can see an image on the back without it being fuzzy, those kind of cameras, you need it to have it at somewhere between 8 and 11. just the way those cameras work, they have actually more depth of field for a bigger aperture. So now you notice we're in a little bit of trouble. We've got to keep the sensitivity of the sensor low to about 100 to 200. We want to keep the shutter speed really fast, so it opens and closes really quick to 1/200 of a second, somewhere in that range. And we've had to keep the aperture small as well, around 22 for SLRs and 8 to 11 for mirrorless cameras. So where are we getting the light from? And the light comes from flashes. So there's two types of flashes you might have seen. You might have seen dual point flashes, which is what I like using, which is this, where you've got two different flashes, dual point, and you've got the ring flash, which has got the ring around the front as well. Now what that allows you to do is it allows you to inject light into the dental photography. So even though we've got low sensitivity of the film, we've got a fast shutter speed, and we've got a small opening, we can pump light into that image for a fraction of a second and get an image that we can see. Now, most of the time, people have their flash set on something called TTL, through the lens. Now, with that, what that means is the camera will try and detect the settings for you, and it will try and adjust the amount of flash it needs to make the image gray. So all cameras, what they try and do is make images gray. So if there's lots of white, it'll use less flash. If there's lots of dark, it'll use more flash. So that's why if you're trying to take dental photography, you notice you take two pictures, one after the other, and one's bright and one's dark. The reason is the camera is trying to figure out how to make an image gray. There's been some slight change. We've shown more gingiva, or you zoomed up more on the teeth, and it's kind of adjust that setting. So the best thing to do is to keep the flash on manual if you want consistent color representation. Now, you're gonna have to experiment with cameras yourself because each flash is different. If you've got dual point, you can have more light. If you've got a ring flash, you might have less light. So you're gonna have to just go on manual with the flash and change it up or down depending on how much light you need. Usually it's the whole light, it's a half, a quarter, a 16th, a 32nd, 1/32, whatever that is, 1/32. And it cuts it down by half each time you wanna lower the settings. Now, the good news is that once you find that setting, because you're gonna be at the same distance most of the time for most of those photos, you won't have to change it again. So to summarize, basically what we need to do is we need to keep the sensitivity of the film or the sensor low, so the ISO to 100, 200. You wanna keep the shutter speed as fast as you can, so somewhere, not as fast as you can, but fast enough to freeze time, so 1/200th of a second, so 1/200. You want to keep the aperture smallish so you get depth of focus from the forward to the back of the teeth. So for SLRs, you want 22, or for mirrorless cameras, somewhere between 8 and 11. And you want to try and use the flash on a manual setting so that you get consistent amount of light that's been pumped in to the image. That means you need to set the camera on manual to take consistent dental photography. So does that sound really hard? You've got to remember all these things, the ISO, the aperture, the shutter, the flash? Not really. But you know what? If you do think that's hard, there's great news for you. My next video is going to be about how to change only one setting on the camera, and you're going to take beautiful pictures for patient communications. Now, if you're a photography pro and you want to have side-by-side comparison images with color accuracy, this may not be for you. But if you're like me and you're just primarily using it to communicate with patients, to give them understanding of their treatment options so they can decide what they want to do, this is brilliant. Because you can pick up a camera and in a few seconds just change one setting and get perfect pictures. Now, if you want to see those videos, make sure you hit the subscribe button, because that's a way that I get to know that you like what I'm doing. And that's completely free. It's on YouTube down the bottom there somewhere. And hit that subscribe button and I get a notification saying that somebody else has liked this video and wants to see more. Once you've done that, you'll see a little bell icon. With the bell icon, basically you get an email sent to you every time I upload a video saying there's a new video. So you don't have to wait and find it from somebody else or one of your other friends in the dentist that there's a good video. You'll see it up front, first up. Now, I hope you enjoy these videos. It's been fun making them, and I can't wait to show you the next one. This is DrTiv, over and out.